Okay, hi guys, this is actually Obi from Occupy News Network. And actually, this is actually cancelled HS2 immediately. It's a petition in parliament.co.uk, and we're about to just talk to this person. Sorry, what's your name?
Mark.
Okay, you're part of the cancelled HS2 immediately.
Yep.
What's the name of the group officially?
Well, we are a group of groups, basically, but essentially we're a soft HS2, we're Hillingdon Green Party, we're victims of HS2.
Mm-hmm.
We've all got our own Facebook pages, but we are all committed to stopping HS2 and getting this petition signed. It's the cancel HS2 immediately.
Mm-hmm.
It's online on the Parliament website.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to stop it now. HS2 is going to cost us £110 billion.
Mm-hmm.
Our children and our grandchildren are going to be paying for it. It's completely wiped out democracy to get to where it is.
Yep.
Has ignored democracy entirely. It's going to be wiping out nature reserves just down the road behind us. It's mm-hmm. going to be wiping out...
is that the Colne Valley one, is it?
Yeah, in the Colne Valley. They're going to be wiping out nature reserves. They're going to be punching big holes into the aquifer that supplies 22% of London's water.
Mm-hmm.
They're doing all sorts of things that they haven't got any engineering background for. They're building a tunnel through the Chilterns, and it's just going to be act as a drain to all the rivers. It's going to drain out the rivers.
Mm-hmm.
There's so many things that they are doing wrong that they haven't worked out. They haven't even planned all the stations yet. They haven't even planned the whole line yet.
I thought there's only one station, Birmingham and London, that's it.
Well, they've only just handed out the design brief for Euston.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't even know the track layout there. So I'm like, how can you design a station without the track layout? And yet they're already evicting people in Euston.
Mm-hmm.
Just before Christmas, without any compensation, without any help.
Are these all CPOs again?
Compulsory purchase orders. There are more happening out here. And in fact, one of the only, I think, as far as I can make out, the only compulsory purchase order that is going to give anybody any compensation in London is Boris Johnson's dad.
Okay.
Did
he run in this area, didn't he, Boris Johnson?
No, he's Parliament Hill, that sort of area.
Okay.
So essentially the enormous amount of money, the ridiculous waste, it's not just a little railway, it's going to be the width of a motorway.
Okay.
And it goes all the way to Edinburgh.
How about the counter-argument from people saying that it's going to allow people to, from Birmingham to London to be able to, say, commute more? So you could have maybe Londoners in the future buying houses in Birmingham, which is at the moment about £140,000 for a three-bed. They could buy a house there and then actually pay another, well, Virgin at the moment charges £10,000 for a season ticket. They could just buy a house in Birmingham, pay the £10,000 a year, which is probably going to increase, and then commute to London to work. Don't you find that would be a good idea?
Well, as far as I can make out, HS2 expect that the only people who will be able to afford to go on HS2 will be on £75,000 or more a year.
Mm-hmm.
There are no stations in between London and Birmingham, so everybody in between is ignored.
Mm-hmm.
And yet we still have to put up with, just up the road here, we're going to have 500 trucks on. In fact, this road might even have a good few trucks on it.
Mm-hmm.
But 500 trucks a day for the next 7 years. It's not worth £110 billion. A 20-minute saving is not worth £110 billion.
Yeah, there's a good point. £110 billion of public money and then to be spent for...
And the money is being borrowed from China.
We
don't know what the final interest rates are going to be. The whole thing is just bunkum. It's just weird, weird thinking. And it's all come through because of this hybrid bill thing,
mm-hmm.
which allows the idea to go through before you do all the planning. So there is no planning. There is no proper planning for the whole thing.
So who's actually... Do you know who's... I was just reading yesterday that... for instance, there's a building company, I'm not going to mention who, that that received the contract to renovate the Big Ben, the clock tower.
Uh-huh.
But it was... I think it was £26 million. And then that suddenly it's now gone up double the price, £52 million. So you have to wonder who actually does these contracts, because if I'm in my line of work, I'm a builder. If I suddenly say, oh, it's going to cost double the amount of money once I start working, I wouldn't have. I don't think the client would necessarily be very happy about it and actually pay that the double the price. It sounds like it's like a scam.
Yeah.
But do you have any? I don't know. Like any investigation on actually the people holding these contracts, who will be holding the contracts?
We don't really know. I'm like there are a lot of the contracts have been handed out. I can't honestly see how they can possibly hold to their present quotes because they don't have any planning. They don't know what everything's going to be, how everything's going to be laid out. They don't know how the stations are going to be. They haven't even designed the bridges. They haven't even designed the tunnels.
Okay.
How can they work out what the money is? It's going to cost a lot more. Okay. Than they are claiming.
So it's basically it's going to be some other people saying that this is going to be white elephant.
It's going to be a white elephant, and the money is going to go up and up.
Well, someone's going to make money.
Yes, and it's not us.
Okay, so your name again is
Mark.
Okay, and you're from the Hillingdon Green Party. Okay, guys, that's actually Mark. Hillingdon Green Party. Cancel HS2 immediately. And this is Obi. Okay, the petition is the Parliament. You can also look at Hillingdon Green Party for the petition, for the link. And then that's it, really. Okay,
excellent.
Okay, this is
Thank
Obi.
You very much.
I shall see you later on. Okay, peace out, guys.
Thank you.